Hello everyone, today we will discuss about the Bragg's law. For this, let us consider a set of parallel lattice planes of a crystal separated by a distance d. If we see this figure, then it is observed that these are the set of parallel planes and that planes are separated by a distance small d. Okay, after that we consider when a narrow monochromatic beam of X-ray having wavelength lambda is incident on this plane, then it make an glancing angle theta as shown in this figure. For example, now here a monochromatic beam of X-ray having wavelength is lambda is incident on this plane, it make an glancing angle. Glancing angle means angle between the incident plane, incident beam and the plane. That angle is nothing but the glancing angle, and is as shown in this figure. Okay, after that consider a ray AB reflected at point B and goes to the direction along BC. Now here we can see a ray AB, this ray AB is reflected from the point B and goes along the direction BC. Now another ray, ray DE, here it is, DE is reflected from the point E and goes along the direction EF. After that, draw two perpendicular BG and BH. Now here we can see there are two perpendicular drawn, one is the BG and other one is the BH. Now BG drawn on a DE and BG drawn on DE and BH drawn on EF. EF. Okay. Now the path difference between the two rays is nothing but GE plus EH. Now the path difference between these two rays is nothing but the GE plus EH. Okay. Now we know that the condition for the constructive interference to take place if path difference is equal to n lambda. Now here from this two equation, the left hand side of these two equations are same, that is path difference, and hence therefore the right hand side of these two equations are also same. Hence we can write the equation path difference is equal to GE plus EH. Sorry, instead of this equation we write GE plus EH is equal to n lambda. Okay. Now if we see again the figure, then it is observed that the GE is equal to EH. GE is equal to EH. Now here we have to find out either value of GE or EH. Okay. Now again from the figure, here we have to calculate the value of GE. For this, consider this triangle, and from this triangle sine theta is equal to what we get. Sorry. Now here we have to find out the value of GE. So for this, consider the triangle BGE. Okay. Now from this triangle, the sine theta is equal to what we get, GE divided by BE. Now here again if we see this figure, then the value of BE is equal to D. Okay. So GE divided by D we get. GE divided by D. Okay. And therefore GE is equal to what we get, D into sine theta. Hence EH is also D sine theta. Okay. Now therefore the equation 2 becomes. Here in equation 2 we put the value of GE and EH. So d sin theta plus d sin theta is equal to n lambda. Therefore we get 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. Here n is equal to 1, 2, 3 for first order, second order, etc. And this relation is nothing but the Bragg's law. This equation we can say that Bragg's equation. Okay. Now next point we'll discuss about the X-ray diffraction. Now the X-ray diffraction was discovered by the scientist Rongtun in 1895. The physical nature of the X-rays was unknown for many years, and hence two theories were put forwarded regarding the nature of the X-ray. Now first theory is related to the X-rays are high-speed particle with very high penetration power. First theory regards X-rays have high-speed particle with high penetration power. And second theory regards X-rays are electromagnetic waves with high frequency. So these two theories put forward regarding physical nature of the X-ray. A number of experiments were performed to test the wave nature of the X-ray, but success could not be obtained. So another scientist, Max van Leeuw or Louis, was first physicist to suggest that crystal acts as a grating for X-ray. Now that means in his experiment he used grating acts as a crystal. Okay, so this is the experimental arrangement of the Max van Leeuw's, as shown in this figure, or these are the experimental setup. Okay, now in this setup we can see that X-ray tube is there, lead screens are there, zinc sulfide acts as a crystal, there is a photographic plate, or we can say that Leeuw's pot. Okay, now the construction is X-ray beam is passed through the pinholes S1 and S2 in the lead screen L1 and L2. Here this is the X-ray tube, and the X-ray beam produced by using this X-ray beams are produced by using this X-ray tube. So that X-ray beam passed through the pinholes S1 and S2 through the lead screen L1 and L2. Okay, this beam again allowed to pass through a thin crystal of zinc sulfide. Now this is the zinc sulfide crystal, and that beam is passed through this zinc sulfide crystal. After that, the transmitted beam was received on the photographic plate. After transmitting this zinc sulfide crystal, that beams are recorded on a photographic plate, okay, which is placed perpendicular to the beam. Like this. Okay, now that plate is developed after exposure of many hours, and the pattern on the plate consists of central dark spot and a series of many faint spot. This symmetrical pattern of the spot is known as a Leeuw pattern or Leeuw spot. Understood? Means what? Now here, X-ray beams produced from the X-ray tube, that beam passed through the pinholes S1 and S2 through the lead screen L1 and L2. Okay, that beam again passed through the zinc sulfide crystal. After passing through the zinc sulfide crystal, that beams are recorded on a photographic plate. After developing this photographic plate, we get dark spot at the center and many faint spot around that dark spot, and hence we can say that is called as a Leeuw spot or Leeuw pattern. So this is about the X-ray diffraction. Now after that we'll discuss about the Moseley's law. Moseley's is the name of the scientist, and during the year 1913-14 Moseley's carried out a study of characteristic X-ray spectra of various metallic element. Now he found that X-ray spectra of different elements are similar to KLM series. Second thing he found that the frequency of lines for the element of higher atomic number is greater than element of lower atomic number. Means the element having higher atomic number, that element have higher frequency compared to, or greater frequency compared to the element having lower atomic number. So mathematically we can relate the relation between the frequency and atomic number is mu is proportional to z minus a bracket square. Here this equation we can write like this: v is equal to b into z minus a bracket square. Give equation number 1. Now here v is the frequency of characteristic radiation, b is nothing but the proportionality constant, and a is nothing but the screening constant. Now for K alpha lines, we take the value B is equal to 3 by 4 R. Here R is nothing but the Rydberg constant, and put here a is equal to 1, and therefore we can write the equation like this: mu of k alpha, which is equal to 3 by 4 r in bracket z minus a bracket square. Now give equation number 2. Now here the equation 1, now this equation 1, that equation is known as a Moseley's law or Moseley's equation. So statement, we can state the law: the frequency emitted by the spectral lines of characteristic X-ray spectrum varies directly as the square of atomic number Z of the element.